Hello, Real Fluency friends. I'm Tricia from Real Fluency Now. And in this lesson, I'll share 5 tips with you for learning phrasal verbs. But first, I promise I'll be fast with this. I'll quickly answer some common questions about phrasal verbs. What are phrasal verbs? Phrasal verbs are verbs that are made up of 2 or 3 words. The first word is a verb and the others are either a preposition, an adverb, or both. And the meaning of the phrasal verb isn't usually obvious based on the meanings of the individual words. For example, fed up. I like using this one as an example. Most English learners know that fed is the past tense of the verb to feed, but don't know the meaning of fed up. It has nothing to do with eating. It means to be angry, irritated, annoyed, or bored by something that has been happening for too long. For example, if a dog is outside barking loudly at night while you are trying to sleep, and it just keeps barking, after a while you will feel fed up with the barking. Why is it important to learn phrasal verbs? Because there are many, many phrasal verbs in English, and they are used a lot in informal everyday speech. So to be able to understand native speakers or to be able to sound like us, you need to know a lot of phrasal verbs. Now, why are phrasal verbs difficult to learn? Well, phrasal verbs are very hard for some English learners. They are hard to learn because there are a lot of them, thousands, because the meaning isn't obvious, and because some have more than one possible meaning. Crack up, for example, has 2 completely different meanings, and take off has 5 different meanings. They can also be transitive, intransitive, or separable or inseparable. All these things make learning phrasal verbs very difficult for some English learners. What are the different types of phrasal verbs? Well, phrasal verbs can be either transitive or intransitive, separable or inseparable, but don't let those words scare you. When a phrasal verb is transitive, it just means it needs another word after it, like a direct object, or your sentence will sound incomplete to a native speaker. Intransitive ones don't need another word. An example is to hit on someone. This means to talk to or flirt with someone because you are attracted to them. A sample sentence is, I think he was hitting on me. You can't say, I think he was hitting on. It just sounds incomplete. A separable phrasal verb can have another word between the verb and the preposition or adverb. Inseparable ones do not have a direct object between them. Now remember, some are strictly separable and must be kept separate at all times, and some others are never separated. For example, some can be separated but don't have to be. To use the example I used before, crack up, or to crack someone up, which means to laugh a lot or to make someone laugh a lot. You can say, he is so funny, he cracks me up. Or you can say, he is so funny, he makes me crack up. And some are never separated. Now I'll share 5 tips for learning phrasal verbs. But what you shouldn't do, like all vocabulary, it doesn't work very well just to go through a list and just try to memorize them all. The first tip is that it's best to learn them in context. On my YouTube channel, I have a lot of videos about phrasal verbs, and I always give some sample sentences with them so you can hear how they are used. I also have an online course where I teach 50 or so phrasal verbs, and I teach them and use them in a story. You can learn more about that right here. Tip number 2, practice making your own sentences with the phrasal verbs as you use them. This will help you to remember them. I always ask people to do this in the comments of my videos, but most people seem too shy to do it. But it's a really good opportunity to practice English. You should do it. You really should. Do it on this video. When it's finished, say hello to me in the comments. Tip number 3, listen for them when listening to native speakers or when reading. Make a list of the ones you find that you don't know the meaning of to look it up later. And notice whether or not they are separated or are followed by a direct object. Number 4, don't try to learn them all at once or even too many at one time. Just pick a few each week to learn and practice with. Number 5, be patient with yourself and just keep learning. Don't give up. And give up is another common phrasal verb. Want to learn the 10 most useful phrasal verbs? Then click here to get a free list with definitions. Or watch more of my English lessons here on YouTube. Goodbye, and remember, with hope, anything is possible.